Since the beginning of June, a notable increase in the rate of earthquakes occurred underneath the infamous Mount Saint Helens volcano. Although minor earthquakes like these regularly occur underneath this volcano on a weekly basis at a rate of around 11 a week, these were occurring at far higher than normal levels, averaging around 35 a week. The U.S. Geological Survey subsequently stated that these quakes are being caused by magma arriving underneath its edifice. So, how concerning are these events? How truly significant is the current unrest, and is a brand new volcanic eruption likely? To quickly answer these three questions, Mount St. Helens is not currently concerning to me as a volcanologist. Episodes of unrest at Mount St. Helens of similar strength occur about every 5.5 years, with the latest activity representing the strongest in a mere 10 months, and a brand new volcanic eruption has, in my opinion, essentially a zero chance of occurring at the present. The reason I say this is that during the last eruption of Mount St. Helens, which lasted between 2004 and 2008, the liquid magma appears to have been drained to a depth of 7 kilometers. In the time since, a portion of magma has been intermittently moving from a deep magma reservoir at 5 to 25 miles depth to the lower portion of the main magma chamber underlying Mount St. Helens at a depth of 2.2 to 4.3 miles. In other words, this magma chamber is indeed refilling, but we still likely are years away and perhaps even decades away from the next eruption occurring. This sort of activity at Mount St. Helens is fairly common, especially since this towering stratovolcano has been the most active lower 48 U.S. states volcano during the last 1,000 years. In that time span, it has produced 18 of the 49 eruptions which have occurred, or, just for the Cascade Mountain Range, 18 of the 37 eruptions there. Mount St. Helens happens to presently be in an active period which began around the year 2500 BCE. These active periods last between 2,000 and 5,000 years each, with four such periods occurring since the volcano first formed. Thus, we can probably expect Mount St. Helens to continue producing a high rate of magmatic intrusions, a few of which will result in volcanic eruptions for up to the next 500 years. Most of these intrusions and episodes of magma building at depth will not result in eruptions, but a low double-digit percentage will. The reason why I do not believe the current unrest will result in an eruption is that magma appears to be at its shallowest a full 1.8 miles too deep on the crust, only reaching up to the middle of Helens' main magma chamber. I would only state an eruption as fairly likely if the small, portable magma chamber at about 1900 feet below sea level started to fill, as that would grant a clear pathway upwards for magma to travel and erupt onto the surface. Since this has not occurred, I am not too concerned. Also, there has been no ground deformation, no changes in volcanic gas emissions such as with carbon dioxide or sulfur dioxide, and the temperatures at various geothermal features surrounding the volcano have not notably changed. All of the aforementioned things would experience changes if magma was intruding to actual shallow depths, such as witnessed before 1980. As a result, the alert level of Mount St. Helens still remains at green. To further expand on my point, on my 0 to 10 opinion-based volcanic unrest intensity scale, I would just barely place Mount St. Helens as a 1. This spot will only increase to a 2, possibly more, if the number of weekly earthquakes spikes to 3 figures.